शंकरुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृत वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावजीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पुरुषं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदेवम् आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शान्तिं शान्ति शान्ति। श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमोमयं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बुद्धिं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मल पारं सर्वं स्थामतिः। There's a Mahasabha of sparrows going on here. Okay. Just a second. Okay, so in the sixth chapter, the 357th avarta, I think we finished the tippana there, Chadu Sutra. So Tarkikas, Nayayikas and Vaisheshikas, their mata is being looked at. त्वं मनसो संयोगेन आत्मनि ज्ञानम् उत्पद्यते आत्मा स्वभावतः जड़ा इति एकदेशी नैयायिक मतम्। सो वन पार्ट ऑफ नैयायिकस वन ग्रुप ऑफ नैयायिकस दे से दैट दी चैतन्य ज्ञान चैतन्य रूप ज्ञान विच इज देयर दैट राइजेस इन द आत्मा चैतन्य जड़ आत्मा बिकम्स चेतन ड्यू टू Tvak and Manas Sanyoga. When the body skin comes in touch with the Manas. So the Sukshma Sharira gets in touch with Stula Sharira. That's the whole and soul of it. Otherwise, Atma is Svabhavata Jada. Kashchana Eka Deshi Tvachasa Manasa Sanyoga Jnanasya Karanam Aha. So who is that here? Kashchana Nayayika De Kashchana Nayayika Ekadeshi. Twachasa Manasa Sanyogam Jnanasya Hetu Maha Tanna Yuktam. The Twacha and Manas Sanyoga causing Jnana in Jada Atma, thereby Atma becoming Chetana, is not valid. Tanna Yuktam. Why so? Yatha Manasasa Atmana Sanyoga Jnana Hetu. इत्यत्रापि न किमपि प्रमाणम् अस्ति। अर्लियर वी सॉ दी पक्षा वेर मनस एंड आत्मा संयोग मेक्स आत्मा चेतना। हियर त्वचा एंड मनस संयोग मेक्स आत्मा चेतना। देर इज नो प्रमाण फॉर ईदर। So just like earlier you didn't have pramana, now this fellow also, this group of nayayikas also does not have any pramana. Ityatra kimapi pramanam asti tatha tvachasa sanyogaha jnana hetuhu. Ityatra api shrutyadi rupam kinchidapi pramanam nasti. There is no pramana for either paksha. Pramana siddha svakapola kalpita vastabhyupagame मृगतृष्णाम्भसि स्नातः खपुष्पकृतशेखरः एष वन्द्यासुतो याति शशशृङ्गधनुर्धरः इत्यादि वाक्यार्थ अपि अंगीकार्यो भवेत्। इफ एनीथिंग दैट इज इमेजिन्ड इज एक्सेप्टेबल अंडर द गार्ब ऑफ लॉजिक देन यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट व्हाट एल्स यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट व्हिच इज लैकिंग प्रमाण। मृगतृष्णाम्बसि स्नातः सो समबडी हु हैज टेकन अ सॉरी बाथ इन मृगतृष्ण अंबसी इन द वाटर ऑफ व्हाट मिराज वाटर समबडी हु हैज बेथ्ड इन मिराज वाटर खपुष्प कृतशेखरः एंड ही हैज a flower, he or she, whoever, has a, but here masculine, so therefore we say he. has flower which is plucked from the sky. Esha Vandyasuta, who is that person? That person is the son of a barren woman. He is going, Yati. Shasha Shrunga Dhanurdharaha, holding a bow which is made up of rabbit's horns. So everything is mithya there. Everything is not mithya, tuchha. So you'll have to accept tuchha also. Swakapola kalpita. If pramana siddha it isn't. Pramana asiddha swakapola kalpita vastu abhyupagame. If you accept such a vastu, this is the case of these nayayikas where the sambandha between atma and manas or manas and twacha itself has no pramana to make atma chetana. Tasmat twachasa manasa sanyoga na jnana hetuhu. That is not acceptable. Shushuptau twacha manasa sanyoga bhavyapi prajnyavatam buddhyadyagamyam sukha ajnanayoho samanya jnanam bhavati tannasya tvangmanaso sanyogasya jnana hetutva abhyupagame. This is a paksha we have seen earlier. The same refutation which is used in the earlier case of Atma and Manas Sanyoga. Here, Tvak Manas Sanyoga also, if that was the karana for Jnana in Atma, then Sukha and Ajnana, Samanya Jnanam in Sushupti, due to Tvacha and Manas Sanyoga won't be possible because Manas undergoes Laya. Tasmat Tvang Manaso Sanyoga Jnana Karanam Kintu Atmana Swarupam Eva Jnanam Iti Shruti Siddhartha Angi Kartum Uchitaha. So what is acceptable is only that which Shruti talks about. That Jnana is the very Swarupa, Chit is the very Swarupa of Atma. It has nothing to do with any Sanyoga of anything with anything. So kashchana ekadeshi twachasa manasa sanyogam jnanasya karanamah atmanasa sanyogam na karanamah. Atma manas sanyoga is not the karana for jnana in atma, but twacha and manas sanyoga is what they talk about. One group of nayayika shushupto kuritan navaka nadya manas praveshati atas twachasa manasa sanyoga nasti. And what do they say in shushupti? What happens in this purita Nadi, the mind enters. Therefore, there is no Tvacha and Manas Sanyoga in Shushupti. Tasmat Shushupto Jnanam na Utpadyate. Therefore, Jnana isn't there in Shushupti. Etanmate Tvachasa Sanyukta Mana Eva Jnana Dwara Dukkha Hetutva Dukkhamityuchyate. So that mind which is connected to Tvacha, actually in Sanskrit twach, but twak, but then in other languages, Indian language, we say twacha. So used to saying twacha there, but twak. Twak is the pratipadikam and sorry, the pada also. So along with twacha, when there is, so twacha itself means along with. It's a tritiya. So twacha saha sanyuktam mana, that mind which is connected to the twak is the dukkha hetu by causing jnana in atma. And we have seen earlier that moksha swarupa of atma is jada. So making atma chetana is dukkha hetu. Exactly opposite to what it should be. Because it's your swarupa, and in moksha, if someone says that, you will be unconscious. Who wants that kind of a moksha? So dukkha hetutva dukkha mityuchyate natu kevalam manah. So this mind independently by itself is not dukkha, but when it is connected to twak, it causes jnana in the jada atma, therefore becomes a dukkha hetu, and therefore it is called as dukkha. Mokshe twachaha nashat tayasa sanyoga bhava jnanam na utpadyate. So twacha is, twak isn't there in moksha because there moksha is not jivan mukti, it is videha mukti. The body drops off, Tvak isn't there. Therefore, there is no connection of the Nitya Manas. Manas is Nitya. It cannot connect with Tvak because Tvak isn't there. Manas is very much there, but it is not Dukkha Karana anymore because Jnana is not Utpanna in Atma. Moksha Kale Manah Asti. So mind is there because it is Nitya. Parantu Dukkha Hetu Jnana Janakam Tvak Sanyuktam Yan Manah Tasya Sanyoga Nashat Nasho Bhavati. So Tvak Sanyukta Mana isn't there. Manas, which is Tvak Sanyukta, that isn't there. Therefore, Sanyoga Nashat Nasha, as good as Nasha of all Dukkha. Itham Moksha Dashayam Paramatmanah Bhinnah Dukkha Rahita Vyapaka Atma Jada Rupah Tishtati. This Atma in Moksha Dasha is Jada, also Paramatmana Bhinna. It is not one with Ishvara. So there's a tippana on that. Nyayamate Atma Vibhur Jadascha Iti Angi Kratam. So Atma is Vibhu, all pervasive, but Jadaha, insentient. Tad etat Shruti Viruddham. It is opposed to Shruti. We know the Shruti, but anyway. Tippanakara mentions that Atrayam Purusha Swayam Jyotir Bhavati Yoyam Vijnanamaya Praneshu Yadyantar Jyoti Purushaha Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma Prajnanam Brahma Ityajyaneka Shruti Vakye Vyapakasya Atmanaha Chetana Swarupatvam Shruyate Yuktayaha Api Ante Mule. These 369 and 372. Between them Avarteshu Varneshyante Ataha Atma Swarupata Jadaha Iti Nayayekoktir Asangata. This Atma being Jada is opposed to Shruti as well as Tarka. Tarka will be presented later, 369 to 372. But Shrutis are these. Swayam Jyoti has been mentioned. This Jyoti is Chetana Swarupa. Vijnanamaya Jnana is very Swarupa of Atma. Jnanam Satyam Jnanam Anantam. Then Prajnanam. All these words are there in mantra. God knows where Tarkikas get their Pramana. Jnana Gunena Ki Atma Prakashate. This Atma Prakasha is Jnana Prakasha. Prakasha and Jnana, when you talk about Prakasha, it is manifest. This Jnana is Chetana. Jivasya Sarvam Jnanam Indriya Janyamivana Nityam. Now this Jiva having manifest Jnana is what? It is Indriya Janyam. Na Nityam. Tachya Indriya Jam. So Indriya Jatam Tachya Indriya Jam Sarvam Jnanam Moksha Kale Nashtam. In Moksha Kala, that kind of Indriya Janya Jnana isn't there. Tasmat Prakash Rahita Jadarupa Atma Moksha Dashayam Vartata Iti Nyaya Siddhanta. This is the reason for their confusion. When they say every jnana which is there is indriya janya, like the French concluding that I think therefore I am. So whether it is due to manas or due to indriya, jnana seems to be only related to some outward vishaya. So without that, what is the swarupa of atma? If you base it on Shuddha Tarka, Shushka Tarka, which is not Shuddha really, Shushka Tarka, it will be an erroneous conclusion. It can be an erroneous conclusion that Atma is Jada. So Moksha Dasha also will be similar. Atma will be Jada. Nyayamate Atmanaha Anekatva Vyapakatvayor Upapadanam. Nayayikas say that Atma is Vyapaka Vibhu and Nana also. Aneka. How is that possible? So they describe this in a following manner. Nyayamate Purvoktaritya Sukadukka Bandamokshaha Atmanaha Sambhavanti. Atma has Sukadukka really and Bandamoksha also really. Ataha Atma Anekaha Sarvatra Vyapakascha. So each Atma has Sukha Dukkha and Bandha Moksha. While one Atma has Sukha, the other may be having Dukkha. jiva. When one jiva has moksha, others continue in bandha. This is something that an Advaitin also says. Who is following aneka jivavada. Sukha dukkha is not atma swarupa at all. So Advaitins do not talk about this. Bandha moksha vyavastha, how do you explain? One jiva is mukta, others do not become mukta. Others continue in samsara, they are baddha. So the vyavastha is explained differently in different prakriyas in Advaita Vedanta. Nayayika say that since this is so, since this vyavastha exists, that bandha moksha is varying across jivas, sukha dukkhas are varying across jivas, therefore ataha atma anekaha sarvatra vyapakascha. Sakala alpa padartha isa. So this ataha, the hetu given earlier, does not land in the sarvatra vyapakascha. Vyapakatva means there as an axiom. Sakala alpa padartha isa sanyoga eva nyayamate vyapakasya lakshanam. Natu sajatiya vijatiya swagata bheda shunyatvam. Now there is an important differentiation. What is the lakshana? What is the definition of this vyapakatvam? Vyapakatvam kim? What is this vyapakatvam? In Advaita Vedanta, the definition is different. That is why you cannot have multiple vyapakatvas. If you have one vyapakatva, other becoming vyapaka is itself out of place. So, sakala alpa padarthaihi saha sanyogaha. This atma having sambandha with all sorts of padarthas, which are themselves not infinite, purna. So they are not vyapaka rather. So atma has a sanyoga with all alpa padarthas. That itself, atma having, what is that sanyoga? Sanyoga which is possible with all alpa padarthas, that is vyapaka. That is the lakshana of vyapakatvam. So sakala alpa padarthaihi saha sanyogaha eva. That much is the definition, that is the lakshana of vyapaka. Natu sajatiya vijatiya swagata bheda shunyatvam. Which is the case in Advaita. In Advaita, if you say Atma is Vyapaka versus in Nyayamata, you say Atma is Vyapaka. What is the difference? Nayayika says Atma has Sanyoga with all Alpa Padarthas. So Ghatapatadi Alpa Padarthas, does Devadatta as Atma have some Sanyoga in Nyayamata? There is sanyoga. Ghatapata sanyoga is there. Yajnaratta also has a sanyoga with ghatapata. Both are seeing them, cognizing them together. Due to that sanyoga, whatever is the way of sanyoga, jnana is utpanna in Devadatta as well as Yajnaratta. You're looking at atma. Devadatta as one atma, jivatma, and Yajnaratta as one jivatma. Both have sanyoga with ghatapatadi alpa padartha. So sakala alpa padartha is sahi sanyoga. Therefore Devadatta atma, jivatma is vyapaka, as well as Yajnaratta jivatma is vyapaka. Two vyapakas. They are really two different atmas and vyapakas. There is no contradiction. Why? Sanyoga can be multiple times. Sorry, in programmatic language they say singleton. So you have a singleton, single instance. You cannot have multiple instances. So you know, some applications, if you are opening, you can't open the application again. If you open the application again, it will open the same window which is already open. So in this, is this atma has sambandha with sanyoga with these alpa padarthas. Now you have another atma. Can it have sanyoga with these or not? Sanyoga is possible. Nayayika says sanyoga is possible. So vyapaka definition is met. So atma one, atma two is a possibility. There can be multiple atmas because sanyoga is possible. That shows the atma is vyapaka. So not only atma one and atma two, multiple atmas are possible. These atmas are vyapaka. And there is no contradiction between vyapakatvam of atma one, atma two, etc. Because lakshana is what? Sanyoga. They can have sanyoga. Now this has to be refuted. If you want to say that there cannot be multiple atmas because multiple vyapakas are not possible, then you have to look at his definition. What is our definition? Sajatiya vijatiya swagata bheda shunyatvam vyapakatvam. So atma is vyapaka when an Advaitin says there cannot be any other atma at all, anatma also at all. Why? Because vyapakatvam means sajatiya vijatiya swagata bheda shunya shunyatvam. So there is no sajatiya atma, there is no other atma. Then only you can say atma is vyapaka. Is there another anatma? Is there any anatma other than atma? That will be vijatiya bheda. There cannot be anything other than brahmatma. Brahmatma is one, cannot have another brahmatma. There isn't another brahmatma. There cannot be any other abrahma also. Abrahmatma is not possible. Within the same brahmatma, swagata bheda, is it possible? No. So sajatiya bheda, we know example, sajatiya bhedas. I just mentioned the exemplified atma itself, but if you look at sajatiya bheda, where is it possible? So same species. So you look at trees, sajatiya, there can be several trees. So trees are different from ghatapatadi, sajatiya bheda. Vijatiya, there can be, so sajatiya bheda can be within the same tree species. There can be different types of trees. So vijatiya bheda would be tree versus non-tree. Sajatiya would be trees of the same species, but then you have jackfruit trees, you have flowering trees, you have orange, you have, you know, mango trees, and those will be sajatiya bheda. So between the trees, there is bheda. Between the trees and non-trees, there is vijatiya bheda. And swagata bheda is the tree itself. If you take a single member of a species of trees, mango tree also, there will be parts. Mango is different. The trunk is different. The branches are different. Leaves are different. And so on. Roots are different. That is swagata bheda. Brahma has none of these. There is no abrahma. There is no other brahma. There is no abrahma. There is no part in Brahma. That is the definition of vyapakatvam. Nyayamate yadyapi atmanah niravayavatvat svagata bheda shunyatvam atmani sambhavati tathapi sajatiya vijatiya bheda shunyatvam na sambhavati. So Nayayikas say that atma is niravayava, therefore svagata bheda shunya, atma is svagata bheda shunya, has no parts at all. However, there can be other atmas and there can be other non-atmas. Kintu sajatiya dvitiya atmanah bhedaha atmani asti. But in atma, each and every atma, in devadatta as atma, you look at devadatta as atma, that devadatta as atma has bheda from other atmas. So sajatiya dvitiya atmanah bhedaha atmani asti. Similarly, yajnyadatta will have bheda atma, as atma will have bheda from all other atmas. Devadatta's atma, it is different from, and so on. Tatha vijatiya ghatapatadi rupa anatma bhedascha atmani asti. Devadatta and Yajnirata will also have bheda. What kind of bheda? Vijatiya bheda. Bheda from ghata, bheda from pata, ityadi is also resting in Devadatta and Yajnirata, who are atma. Two atmas. We shall actually be using Pratipadikams in Sanskrit. So Atmans, you know, in earlier books you will see this Atmans, Atman. Tasma Sajatiya Vijatiya Swagata Bheda Shunyatvam Na Vyapakasya Lakshanam Kintu Sarvalpa Padartha Sanyogitvam Neval Tal Lakshanam. So the definition has to be clear. Otherwise, you know, we are discussing on different pages. You should be having some common understanding of what the other is saying. Then only you can either agree, disagree, or give a separate explanation to it. That otherwise debate and discussions are not possible. You should understand each other's definitions. So when Nayayika says that Atma is Vyapaka but Aneka, we say, oh, there is a Virodha. He says, how do you say that there is Virodha? We say that Sajatiya Vijatiya Swagata Bheda Shunyatvam Vyapakatvam. He says, no, Swagata Bheda Shunyatvam is all right, it is possible, but that is not my Lakshana. He says, Sarvalpa Padarthaihi Sanyogatvam Vyapakatvam. So that is not countered. You have to counter that to show that multiple Atmas are not possible. Being Vyapaka, multiple Vyapaka Atmas are not possible. So here you have sarva alpa padarthai sanyogitvam. Tal lakshanam is vyapakasya lakshanam. There's a tippana there. Okay, first we look at the siddhanta definition. Siddhante, advaita siddhante, sajatiya vijatiya swagata bheda bhavaha vyapakasya lakshanam. We saw that. What is the basis? Sadeva somedam agravasit. Ekameva dvitiyam. Chandogya Shruti is there, which says Sat eva somya idam agra asit. Agre srishtev prak asit. This atma idam is idam jagat srishtev prak ekameva dvitiyam asit. It was there as one without a second. Before what? Before Srishti. So is it not one now? Or is it not there now? No, it is there. Idam, because you are idam taya, you are looking at this jagat as idam. Idam jagat. Now it also has nama rupa, which is mithya. Iti chandogya shrutyanusari idam lakshanam. So this definition has basis in shruti. How so? When you say it as Eka, Eka means there is no other. So when you say this Prapancha itself was one without a second earlier in unmanifest form, there was no name and form. So Atma alone was there. There was no Anatma, there was no other Atma, because Ekam is there. Ekam. Eva Advitiyam. All three are there. Ekam is sufficient. But Eva Kara is also added. When you say Ekam Eva, then further negation. Ekam itself negates another. But Eva Kara negates further. Sorry. Advitiyam, third negation. So these three negations, Ekam, Eva and Advitiya, all three are showing Sajatiya, Vijatiya, Swagata, Bheda, Abhavaha. So atra ekapadena sajatiya bhedo nishidhyate evakarena vijatiya bheda nishedo bhavati advitiya padena swagata bheda nishedascha bhavati. So each of these eka pada in the lakshana there, swajatiya bheda abhava, is shown by ekapada. Then vijatiya bheda abhava is shown by evakara. And Swagata Bheda Bhava is shown by Advitiya in this Shruti Mantra. Etal Lakshana Anusarana Deshakala Vastu Krita Paricheda Rahitatvam Api Vyapakasya Lakshanamiti Siddham. And it also means that there is no desha kala or vastu paricheda, because desha paricheda, kala paricheda, vastu paricheda, when you inquire into, is desha atma or anatma? Desha is anatma, but whichever paksha you take, it cannot be opposed to the lakshana. So desha, you say no, desha is atma, then sajatiya bheda is not possible. So desha is not different from atma. If you say desha is anatma, then vijatiya bheda is not possible from atma. Because eka, atma is eka, ekameva advityam, desha cannot fit into that. Similarly, kala or vastu. Therefore, desha kala vastu paricheda, limitation by desha kala or vastu is also negated as well with the lakshana. In Nayayika's mata eka padena, desha krita anta nishiddha. Tatahi yadvastu parichinnam tannana bhavati. Yad vyapakam tannana na bhavati. Kintu akashavad ekameva. Yasmad atma ekaha tasmad na parichinna. Sorry, this is the continuation of this. This is not Nayayika mata. Kintu sarva alpa padartha sanyogitvam eva tallakshanam. So that is being looked at. Sarva alpa padartha sanyogitvam is what is the Nayayika's lakshana. But in that point, what is being said, refutation is shown. Eka padena desha krita anta nishiddha. So limitation in space is refuted by eka pada. In the ekameva advitiyam. Tathahi yadvastu parichinnanta nana bhavati. If a vastu is limited, then there can be multiple there. Tadvyapakam. Yad vyapakam tan nana na bhavati. If you say vyapaka, then it cannot be. Vyapaka is our own definition. From our definition of sajatiya vijatiya, swagata bheda shunya, what is vyapaka cannot be nana. So kintu akasha vadekameva. Akasha is vyapaka. Akasha is not nana. Now we ask the Nayayika, why do you think akasha is not nana? He would say that there is Gaurava, I don't need another Akasha at all. When I can do with one Akasha, I don't need another Akasha at all. So Nana Akasha is Gaurava. Laghava is in accepting one Akasha. Nothing fails in my darshana. Now we tell him, Akasha can be one Vyapaka Tattva. And you can have everything in an Akasha. Why do you take Atma as Nana? There is Gaurava there and not necessary at all. Atma can still be one and Antakarana Bhedas can cause Manas being many. You can have your Darshana as well. Darshana is Vyavastha. The Vyavastha that is there, which is they think is not explainable. If you have one Atma, we say you use the same process, whatever process you use for Akasha being one and still explaining Vyavastha of all the vastus being in Akasha, single Akasha. Use the same process with Atma. What is the problem? But Atma should be one Vyapaka. It cannot be multiple Atmas. Yasmad Atma ekaha tasman na parichinnaha. Since Atma is one, it cannot be limited. Akashavat ekameva. So akashavat atma ekaha. Yasmad ekaha tasman na parichinnaha. Kintu vyapaka. This one ekameva advitiyam, when you say ekam, it cannot be limited at all. Because there is no other number at all. Ekam eva. There is only one. You cannot have anything second. Atma or anatma. So even ekam eva can explain all the bheda shunyatvam, but then there are three, so all three are explained differently. Each word need not necessarily stand for the way it is explained. It can, you know, some tikakara is explained in a different way. But we know that all three words, ekam, eva, advitiyam, refute the three types of bhedas. Nyayamate tu सॉरी तस्मादेव आत्मा देशकृत अंतरहितो भवति. दिस आत्मा इज नॉट लिमिटेड बाय देश. न्यायमति तु नाना व्यापक अंगीक्रियन्ते. दे एक्सेप्ट मेनी व्यापक तत्वास तद अद्वैत श्रुतेर वक्षमाण युक्तेर लोकानुभवस्य च विरुद्धम. सो टिप्पणकार सेज दैट इज अपोज्ड टू श्रुति इज अपोज्ड टू युक्ति इज आल्सो व्हिच इज गोइंग टू कम अप and also anubhava virodha is there. You cannot have multiple vyapakas. There is no anubhava, such anubhava. Ukta shruti gataika padena atmana deshakrita anta nishidhyate. Shruti virodha is right here. Ekam eva dvitiyam. The nayayika's vyapaka definition is aside, setting that aside. You cannot have multiple vyapaka tattvas. Now, अत्र एवं यदि कस्यचित् शंका स्यात्, if there is a doubt here, न्यायमते आत्मवत् आकाशकाल दिशोपि व्यापकः परमाणुश्च सूक्ष्मः निरवयवश्च. Now, न्यायमते, in the नैयायिकस्य दर्शन, आत्मवत् आकाशकाल दिशः अपि व्यापकः. आकाश इज व्यापक, काल इज व्यापक, दिग् इज व्यापक, एंड परमाणु दि atoms are what? You take a single atom. Paramanu sukshmaha. It is minuscule. Niravayavascha. It is partless. Akasha is also partless. All of these are partless. So paramanu is not vyapaka but niravayava. Atma kal dik. They are vyapaka. Niravayavascha. Sukshmaha. Akasha is sukshma. Kala is sukshma. Dik is sukshma. तादृश परमाणुना सह सर्वव्यापक पदार्थानां संयोग न युज्यते. नाउ दिस परमाणु विच इज ऑफ दिस टाइप. विच टाइप इट इज परमाणु. परमाणु एंड व्यापक आर एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट टू ईच अदर. दी वर्ड्स देमसेल्व्स आर अपोजिट. तादृश परमाणुना सह. नाउ वी आर लुकिंग इन टू हिज डेफिनेशन. हिज डेफिनेशन इज वॉट? सर्व सकल अल्प पदार्थ ही सह संयोग व्यापकस्य लक्षणम. वी क्वेश्चन एट दी वेरी रूट. नाउ तादृश परमाणुना सह सर्व व्यापक पदार्थानां संयोग न युज्यते. नाउ दिस आत्म संयोग और एनी पदार्थ संयोग आकाश संयोग विथ परमाणु इज इट पॉसिबल? इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो व्यापकत्वम इज नॉट एस्टैब्लिश्ड इवन इन योर मत. इन योर ओन लक्षण with your own lakshana vyapakatvam cannot be established the way it is established by you. Paramanu yadi savayavah syat tadatasya kvachit deshe atmana sanyogo deshantareshu cha itara vyapaka padarthanam sanyogascha bhavet natu paramanu paramanu savayavah. This paramanu is partless. Had the paramanu had parts, which is what we have seen earlier, one part connects to the other part of another padartha. So one part of one padartha connects to the other part of another padartha. Rather, one part of one padartha connects to one part of the other padarthas, or multiple parts of one padartha connects to the multiple parts of other padartha. Even in science, you get the molecular structure, you look at it, atomic structure, you look at it, the subatomic particles, they interact with each other. This is how the structures are formed. The atom is not partless in science. Now, if you say atom is partless, paramanu, whatever is the size, that is irrelevant, but atom is partless. When you look at it, परमाणु यदि सवयव सैत् तदा तस्य क्वचित् देशे आत्मनः संयोगः देशांतरेषु च इतर व्यापक पदार्थानां संयोगश्च भवेत्. दिस परमाणु एंड व्यापक पदार्थास कैन हैव एन हैव अ संयोग ओनली इफ परमाणु हैज पार्ट्स. परमाणु डज नॉट हैव पार्ट्स. इनफैक्ट द व्यापक आकाश आल्सो डज नॉट हैव पार्ट्स. नतु परमाणु सवयवः. देन हाउ इज सकल अल्प पदार्थ संयोग गोइंग टू बी पॉसिबल? इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी पॉसिबल. किंतु निरवयवः अतिसूक्ष्मश्च परमाणु इज निरवयव एंड अतिसूक्ष्म इट हैज अ वेरी स्मॉल साइज एंड हैज नो पार्ट्स नाउ तस्मात् परमाणुना सह एकस्मिन्नेव देशे सकल व्यापक पदार्थानां संयोगो वक्तव्य नाउ यू हैव टू डिस्क्राइब हाउ इज दिस संयोग विथ ऑल पदार्थास गोइंग टू बी पॉसिबल एकस्मिन्नेव देशे इन वन देश यू विल हैव टू हैव संयोग विथ ऑल व्यापक पदार्थास परमाणु शुड हैव संबंध नाउ ऑल दीज व्यापक पदार्थ विच यू हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट यू पिक देम एंड एक्सप्लेन हाउ दे विल हैव संयोग विथ परमाणु विच इज निरवयव सूक्ष्म अति सूक्ष्म कैन यू एक्सप्लेन वी आस्क द नैयायिका सच न घटते इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल एकस्य व्यापक पदार्थस्य संयोगेन निरुद्धे स्थाने व्यापक पदार्थांतर संयोगस्य असंभवात् एकस्य व्यापक पदार्थस्य संयोगेन इफ वन व्यापक पदार्थ यू टेक एंड यू से ओके देयर इज अ संयोग इन दैट स्थान विच एवर देश देयर इज संयोग इन दैट वेरी देश यू कैनॉट हैव अनदर व्यापक तत्व विच हैज संयोग दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट पॉसिबल तस्मात् नाना पदार्थानां व्यापकत्वं न युज्यते देयर टाइपो हियर सो नाना पदार्थानां व्यापकत्वं न युज्यते व्हाय बाय सेइंग व्यापक पदार्थास् आर व्हाट व्यापकत्वं किम् सकल पदार्थैः सह सकल अल्प पदार्थैः सह संयोगः सो यू टेक व्यापक वन व्यापक टू व्यापक पदार्थ वन व्यापक पदार्थ टू व्यापक पदार्थ वन कैनॉट हैव संयोग विथ वन परमाणु दैट इटसेल्फ इज नॉट पॉसिबल लेट से यू एक्सेप्ट इट इफ यू एक्सेप्टेड इट दैट परमाणु इज इन पर्टिकुलर देश व्यापक पदार्थ वन हैज हैड संयोग विथ इट नाउ व्यापक पदार्थ टू इन द सेम देश इट इज ऑलरेडी हैविंग संयोग हाउ विल द अदर हैव संयोग On this, so I mean, just for the argument's sake, consider a huge cloth as an example for vyapaka tattva. A red, huge red cloth, and there is a huge blue cloth. Now, this red cloth, huge red cloth, vast one, comparable to vyapaka, is covering a pot. This pot has parts anyway. Assume that it's a crystal which has no parts per se. Let's just look at that. Now, if the red cloth is covering that, red cloth is touching that crystal, there is a sanyoga. Now, you want to cover the crystal with the blue cloth. Can you cover it? You cannot cover it. Why? Because there is already the red cloth which is having sanyoga with the ghata, spatika. Now the blue cloth cannot have sanyoga with the spatika. How will it have sanyoga? Now it's vyapakatva you are establishing. The blue cloth is vyapaka because it has sanyoga with all these alpa padarthas. There is crystal, there are many small things under that blue cloth. So you explain that blue cloth is vyapaka. Why? Because it is covering the entire room full of alpa padarthas. Having sanyoga, covering this in sanyoga. There, the blue cloth is having sanyoga with all the things kept in the room. So let's say the red cloth is covering, then it is having sanyoga with all the objects in the room. So then red cloth is vyapaka. Okay. How is the blue cloth going to have sanyoga with the same alpa objects in the room? You cannot have it. So you cannot have second vyapaka. Even in your definition, there is a flaw. We don't expect you to take our definition. We tell the Nayayika, in your own definition, how will you have another vyapaka tattva? There is not going to be sanyoga possible once the first vyapaka tattva, any one vyapaka tattva has had sanyoga with alpa padarthas, sarva alpa padarthas, then you will establish व्यापकत्वम ऑफ दी फर्स्ट व्यापक पदार्थ द सेकेंड व्यापक पदार्थ कैन नॉट बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड एट ऑल बिकॉज देयर इज नो संयोग इटसेल्फ पॉसिबल इनफैक्ट वी हैव सेड दैट फर्स्ट व्यापक तत्व इटसेल्फ द डेफिनेशन विल नॉट होल्ड गुड बिकॉज परमाणुना सह संयोग एव न संभवति बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट रीजन परमाणुनः निरवयवत्वात् बिकॉज इट इज पार्टलेस But hypothetically, if you say the Sanyoga is there, therefore, with all Paramanus, you have Sanyoga of Atma. Let's just assume that. This Atma, first Atma being Vyapaka is established. Let's assume so. How will you have second Vyapaka Atma? Because in whichever Desha you have Sanyoga with all these Paramanus or Alpapadarthas, Sakala Alpapadarthas, you cannot have In the same desha, you cannot have sanyoga of another padartha at all. So, hope that is clear. Now, with that, his own definition is questioned, and by questioning that definition, if that definition holds good, even if it holds good, it will hold good for one padartha, establishing vyapakatvam of one padartha. You will not be able to have another vyapaka siddhi at all. तस्मात् नाना पदार्थानां व्यापकत्वं न युज्यते तस्माद् एकस्यैव पदार्थस्य व्यापकत्व अंगीकारो युक्ता इति 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 व्हाट इति यदि कस्यचित् शंका स्यात् इफ देयर इज समबडी इज डाउट इन दिस मैनर तदेवं समाधानं नैयायिको ब्रूयात् तदा एवं तदा इन इफ समवन वेयर टू हैव सच अ डाउट Meaning the Siddhanti Advaitin objects to Nayayika, then Nayayika would give an answer so in this manner. Savaya Vastunaha Sanyoga Eva Anya Vastu Sanyogam Prati Virodhi. So he has more Tarka now. He says this Virodha that you are talking about, Savaya Vastunaha Sanyoga Eva Anya Vastu Sanyogam Prati Virodhi. Who can have virodha with sanyoga with anya vastu? Savaya vastu naha sanyoga. Only when a vastu has parts, that time what you are saying, that virodha of another padartha not being able to have a sanyoga with a vastu is possible only when it is a savaya vastu. Savaya vastu, in that case you would have been right, but yasmin bhumi pradeshe hastasya sanyoga bhavati tatra padasya sanyoga na sambhavet. So you would be right, says the Nayayika to the Siddhanti, you would have been right. If the case was about things with parts, padarthas with parts, here vastus with parts are not being talked about. Yasmin Bhumi Pradeshe, you are thinking about which example, sir? You are thinking about Yasmin Bhumi Pradeshe Hastasya Sanyoga Bhavati. You are talking about the part of the ground can have parts. Therefore, a part of the ground, Bhumi Pradesha, where you have your hand, in that same place on the ground, you cannot have your leg also. So the Hasta Sanyoga and Pada Sanyoga cannot be with the same Bhumi Pradesha. Na sambhavet, it is right. Why? Because Bhumi is Savayava. Niravayava Vastu Sanyogastu Nasthanasi Nirodhakaha. However, he says that, Nayayika says that the Niravayava Vastu, the Vastu without parts, has no opposition to Sthana. What is this logic? Another Kapola Kalpita. He says if the Vastu is partless, then there is no Sthanasya Nirodha Na Bhavati. There is no possibility of Sthana Nirodha. Tasmat sa na anya sanyogasya virodhi. So the partless will not have any issue with being restricted. That one desha being restricted to one padartha sanyoga is not there at all. That restriction itself does not apply with niravayo vastu. Therefore, there is no virodha there. You can have another vyapaka tattva because many vyapaka tattvas can have sambandha with this paramanu, which is niravayava. Saha ayam anubhava siddhartha. How anubhava siddha? Bhagavan knows. Ghate yatra deshe akashasya sanyogasti tatra eva deshe kaladi kal dishorapi sanyogasti. He says, no, don't bring Bhagavan here, I'll explain. Anubhava siddha. So the tarkika asks the siddhanti, ghate yatra deshe akashasya sanyoga asti tatra eva deshe kala dishorapi sanyoga asti. So he's asking you, the siddhanti, in whichever place there is ghata, is there akasha sambandha? Because you are saying this ghata is in a particular space. Is it in a particular time? Yes. This is how you explain your deshakala, this thing, deshakala parichinnatvam. When you talk about elaborately, he says, I very well know you use tarka very wisely there. So why don't you apply it here? Ghate yatra deshe akashasya sanyoga asti. Tatra eva deshe kaladi kala dishorapi sanyoga asti. So you take one, you look at the ghata. There is one ghata that has sanyoga with akasha. It is in a particular akash space there. It is in one direction also. It is in a particular time also. If you take it away, it won't be there in that time. Another time it won't be there. But in this time, in this space, in this direction, there is the same ghata. Ghatasya yakkopi deshaha yadi akasha kala dibhyo bhaisyat tasmin deshe akasha kala disham sanyoga nasyat. Kintu na tatha asti ghatadi nam akasha kala dibhyo bahirbhuta kashchana deshaha. Further, he explains that akashakal disham sanyoga nasyat. When would that sanyoga of akashakal and dik not be possible? In whichever desha, had the ghatasya yak kopi desha, any part of the ghata, had it been outside akashakal and dik, there is no part of ghata which is outside akashakal and dik, then only the sanyoga wouldn't be possible. Kintu natatha asti ghatadinam akashakala dikvyo bhairhuta kashchana desha. There is no space. There is no space of this. There is no desha. So desha is no part. No part of this ghata which is outside the akashakala and dik. Kintu sakala padarthanam sarvopi desha akashakala dikshweva vartate. When you talk about any padartha, you talk about that padartha with the assumption that it is in a particular space, particular time, and you assume a direction also. So that is all assumed. So you have not inquired into it. He says, if you inquire into it, you know that what I am saying is true. Therefore, anubhava siddha tasmat sarva padarthanam sarveshvapi desheshu akashakala disham sanyogascheva. Anubhava siddha, akasha is vyapaka, kala is vyapaka, jik is vyapaka. They have sanyoga with alpa padartha ghata. In the same desha, they have sanyoga. So this rule that you talk about, hasta and, so hasta and pada having sambandha, that niravayava it doesn't. Akasha is niravayava. So anyway, he is given some kind of explanation. Whether it is acceptable or not, that's how it is. Ittham paramano api ekasmin neva deshe nana niravayava vyapaka padarthanam sanyoga yukta eva. Now see, this analysis may not be interesting at all. It may be interesting to some. It may be too detailed for others. But this will help us with trying to refute the sanyoga of atma with anything. Atma cannot have any sambandha. Not only because of Shruti. Shruti says so, but I feel that I am dukkhi. Why do I feel that I am dukkhi? This is the reason that I want moksha from dukkha. So when you do manana, if you have enough shraddha, then that manana will be little. There won't be much necessity for manana. But anubhava of dukkha continuing, we not being able to resolve that Shruti statement in the right manner, will continue in samsara. So manana is needed. When manana increases, then all these questions would come up. How do I connect with my antakarana? Is there really a connection? Is it possible at all? So all sorts of analysis will come into play. So when we are looking at these sambandhas of the ghatapatadi ityadi, you have to look at it as how it can be useful for my manana in vyapaka versus avyapaka tattva. Whether there is any validity without thinking, have I given some validity to Nayayika's paksha at all? And how it is refuted, how can I fine tune my own inquiry into Atma and Manasanyoga ityadi? Thereby, invalidating the dukkha itself in Atma. So, ittham paramanu api ekasmin neva. Ittham paramanu api ekasmin neva deshe nana niravaya vyapaka padarthanam sanyoga yukta eva. Therefore, multiple atmas can have sanyoga with paramanu also. Anto paramanu, they can have sanyoga. Natra kashchirapi doshosti tasmad atmana tasmad atma nana bhavati sarvatra vyapakascha bhavati iti. So atma can be nana and vyapaka also. Atma vyapaka anekaha karta bhokta cha iti nyayamatasya nirakaranam. So the Siddhanti is going to refute all this now with his own definitions. He is going to use his own tools. Atma is vyapaka aneka. That has been discussed now. Karta and bhokta also. This is going to be refuted. We'll see that in the next part. I will stop here. How much is it? Yeah, we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part. Sukham nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namur adhishthanam buddhye bodhyam buddher drukyatne nirvaparam sarvedanta vidyam pratyek paramaha tadeva annamatto niriti me nischita matihi. Any questions? Namaste.
Arigato.